Good afternoon and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining back on today's live session. Right now, we already have Mr. Bustanul Arifin Cahya, the head of the Agricultural Training Center of Indonesia, with us. So Mr. Bustanul will going to present about government policy on integrated pest and disease management. So without further ado, I will give the floor to Mr. Bustanul. Mr. Bustanul, please, the floor is yours. Thank you. I'm sorry, Mr. Bustanul, I think your microphone is still muted. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mbak Niken. Yeah. Okay, first of all, allow me to present our views regarding the policy and program of agriculture human resources development in Indonesia, and also the main program of the Ministry of Agriculture in building the capacity human resources. As we can see in the slide that President Joko Widodo clearly stated that improving the quality of human resources in Indonesia is very important. There is a need to build agile human resources to support the development of Indonesia. Next, please. In agriculture, human resource has played a significant role. The quality and quantity of human resources working in the agriculture sector in general has been shaping the development of agriculture in Indonesia. The Ministry of Agriculture, Sahrul Yasin Limpo, stated that to be able to attain advanced, independent, and modern agriculture, the promising generation for our future is the young generation. Therefore, there is a need to create 2.5 million a millennial farmer in 2024. This millennial equipped with sufficient knowledge, science and technology will be able to address various issues faced by stakeholders in agriculture. Next, please. Moving the next slide, we would like to inform you that under the Ministry of Agriculture, Indonesia for Agency Agriculture Extension and Human Resources Development has three pillars to support the development of human resources and main program of the Ministry of Agriculture. These pillars are extension, education, and training. Under these pillars, we have three main programs. One, movement of the strategic command for agriculture development in the district, we call Kostratani, and two, extension, education, and vocational training to support the growth of millennial agriculture entrepreneurs. Extension, education, and training to support the main program of the Ministry of Agriculture. Next, please. Next, please. Next. Okay, in this slide, we can see the detail of its programs. In particular, Kostratani is our main program to improve agriculture production. Kostratani is the next, please. Kostratani is the center for agriculture development activities at the sub-district level, which is the optimization of tasks, function and roles of the Agriculture Extension Center, we call BPP, by utilizing IT in realizing national food sovereignty. Next. Ladies and gentlemen, in the next slide, we can see that there are several challenges faced by agriculture to Indonesia, such as a low interest of youth in the agriculture sector, both in employment and entrepreneurship, both on farm and off farm, as well as each year the number of farmers decreased by 500,000 farmers. Meanwhile, looking at opportunities, there are more than 70% people are in the productive age. This productive age group will provide opportunities in developing agriculture in Indonesia, especially youth. The role of youth is to substitute aging farmers because youth is more competitive, more responsive to technology, more adaptable and creative. Next, please. Looking at the next slide, we would like to inform you that under Indonesian Agriculture for Agriculture Extension and Human Resources Development, we have the Indonesian Center for Agriculture Training. Through the vision and mission of the Indonesian Center for Agriculture Training, we are committed to achieve our two main goals, which are to improve skilled labor in the field of agriculture that's fit with the needs, and to create young agriculture entrepreneurs, particularly in the rural areas. These entrepreneurs will be able to create jobs and empower local people to run their business. We hope that the presence of young agriculture entrepreneurs in the rural area will foster the economic development, which will be beneficial for all stakeholders. From this figure, the Indonesia Center for Agriculture Training has 10 centers for training located across Indonesia. Next, please. In the spirit of accelerating the progress of creating qualified human resources as job creator and or entrepreneur, as well as preparing qualified job seeker who meet the needs, there are 5 main programs attached in each center. 1, increase implementation of agriculture training. 2, strengthening agriculture training institution and increasing competence in agriculture training staff. 4, development of standardization and professional certification. And the last, program development and training cooperation network. Ladies and gentlemen, next please. Look at the next slide. In order to promote agriculture to the young generation, the Ministry of Agriculture has implemented Youth for Food through campaign of millennial farmers activities involving millennial agriculture entrepreneurs. From this video, we can see that there are 3 main activities, which are first, vocational training and education, and 2, demonstration plot, and 3, incentives for supporting the millennial young farmers through various programs such as the development of millennial agriculture entrepreneur, cooperation, digitalization, young ambassador, and creating 2.5 million young farmers. These efforts are dedicated to generate millennial agriculture entrepreneur. Next. In this figure, we can see the Ministry of Agriculture initiative to equip millennial to become professional, competitive, and entrepreneur millennial. These activities are vocational education, vocational training, P4S. P4S is the center of training in the field area, and Japanese apprenticeship, and Kostratani, and millennial agripreneur ambassador. Next, please. And this slide, we would like to highlight that agriculture in Indonesia has been experiencing transformation from traditional to modern agriculture. These are massive use of agriculture machinery, IT, and digital platform across agriculture management in Indonesia. In this regard, millennials need to be facilitated in mastering this piece of technology. Government has created enabling environment for promoting agribusiness in a such modern way. For instance, by providing infrastructure, conducting technical training and extension center based on information technology. In addition, the government has strengthened farmer cooperation based on smart agriculture through vocational education, vocational training, and extension officers. The introduction and implementation of modern agriculture has been widely used. Next, please. For example, we can see in this figure there are smart greenhouses to produce high quality vegetables. Meanwhile, most of farmers are currently starting to use agriculture machinery such as a rice transplanter. In this slide, we can see the rice transplanter. The utilization of modern technology in farming will improve productivity and production, Therefore, millennials need to be aware of this kind of piece of technology and must be able to operate it. Next, please. In this figure, we would like to highlight that farmer and millennial farmer who are practicing and utilizing agriculture machinery. IT and digital platform are supporting the government to secure food supply during the crisis. These are some of the millennial who are focusing their business in agriculture sector. As millennial agripreneur ambassador, their roles are to provide food for many Indonesian as well as to generate income and increase farmer welfare. For example, this feature illustrates about how this millennial survived doing the business during the pandemic era. There are the living proof of the resilient agriculture during COVID-19. Next, please. Move on the next slide. We'd like to share some of the success stories of agriculture millennial who earn profit from agriculture. As you can see that these millennials are not only promoting agriculture in the field, but also in the digital platform, such as marketplace and webinars. They share experience and try to influence as many as they can for young generation to join in agriculture. Together with the Ministry of Agriculture, this millennial join force to secure food supply now and in the future. As we can see in the next, that many millennials are in the next slide. Please, next slide. In the next slide, that many millennials are now expanding their business through online marketing to keep delivering food to customers. For instance, Sandy Okta, Susilo from Cianjur, West Java, are conducting his business in horticulture, and Selamat from Sukabumi, West Java, who has been successfully developed a quail farm. And this figure, these are the example of millennial in conducting their business as well as assisting farmer to increase their income. They are not only fulfilling the domestic market, but also exporting their product to the international market. For instance, Kadek Surya from Bali and Jatu from DKI Jakarta are two millennial who are expanding their market to foreign customer around the globe. For the next slide. And the next slide, these are some millennial doing their business as well as assisting farmer to increase their income. For example, Gesang, Husni Tamrin, and so on. And Rizal are millennial farmers who have been partnering with many other farmers in supporting food supply and the current crisis caused by COVID-19 pandemic. Ladies and gentlemen, to conclude my presentation, we would like to state that human resources has played a significant role. Human resources are valuable asset for Indonesia to be able to secure agriculture production in the future. I think that's all. Thank you, Bunikan. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.